You don't want to stay a bit back.
So this is Darrick here, and Darrick is gonna show us one of the coolest things you'll have ever seen.
Come on! Put him up here! Come
on! Look at that. The reason we came all the way to Thailand has just begun. We are en route to Elephant Nature Park.
And it is still happening in our world today.
Really need
During the Dijon process, which can last up to 7 days, they must stay with the elephant, or the young elephant may attempt to kill themselves.
We have arrived. So about an hour and 15 minutes later, we have arrived at Elephant Nature Park here in northern Chiang Mai. If you're just tuning into this vlog, the reason Blake and I have come here to Thailand is actually for a big project that we're working on. It's by the name of Black Tusk. It's gonna be talking about elephant trekking and why you should not support these businesses. You're gonna hear more about the dirty side of elephant tourism, as well as where it should be headed, which is places like this, Elephant Nature Park, that allows you to coexist with the elephants instead of exploiting them.
He's so fat.
He's, yeah. His name is Moo, and Moo is pig in Thai. Because he's a big, chubby, lazy one. This is the kitchen. So where all the food is prepared. Yeah. Look at all that food. I'm sure they must eat so much. 10% of their own weight every day. So this is for the elephants. They're eating better than I do. Feeding 69 elephants is a full-time job for several people here. Each of the elephants here in the Elephant Nature Park have their own mahout. That means 69 elephants, resulting in 69 mahouts. That's a lot of people working here, and that doesn't even include the people who take care of the grounds, the people who are making the food and handling all the admin. So this is a massive production to create a livable environment for these elephants. Where else in the world can you see these amazing creatures? So gentle, so strong, and so intelligent. They were telling us that the brain of the elephant is 5 kilograms in weight, and they remember everything. They can even pass down from generation to generation feelings and emotions. So here is a herd of 3 female elephants. You can see each of them has their mahout just hanging out with them. They're extremely social animals, and that's why it's so important that they're kept with their herd, kept with their pack.
Dream, living a dream, living a dream, living a dream.
I'm just stuck here.
Wow, that is a tooth right there. You'll see rehabilitated dogs roaming throughout the park. There's 400 dogs here, and a lot of them have actually been brought here after the flood in 2011. 70% of Thailand was covered by water, and during that time, they actually rented out boats, and they brought back a bunch of these dogs who basically had no owners after the flood. There's no chains, there's no hooks, there's no mahouts forcing them to go from place to place.
Yeah, baby Darrick, 4 months, the newest.
Newest elephant in the park. Was he born here?
Yeah, born here.
Born in the park. So right here, you've got a massive basket of fruit. This here is Sin Wan, and Sin Wan was born in 1962. She's actually blind in her left eye, and that's probably due to a slingshot. A lot of these elephants are brought into the big cities here in Thailand, and they're used to beg on the side of the road because people know that they can earn a lot of money from tourists. Some of them come from elephant trekking parks, which is one of the more common ways that people interact with elephants in Thailand. And ultimately, this is the purpose of the documentary that we're creating. We want to change that. We want elephant tourism to look a lot more like this. And it's not gonna happen overnight, but we want to slowly nudge people in the right direction. That is what Black Tusk is all about. I've been feeding her for about 5 minutes now. She's eaten 3 pumpkins and at least a couple of watermelons in that short period of time.
I said, man, what I look like, a charity case? I took it and threw it on the ground. I don't need your handouts. I'm an adult.
I don't know where you're gonna find your next meal, but it's not me. So they have 69 elephants, soon to be 71, but even with 250 acres, that is getting a little bit tight for all these elephants. So they're constantly looking for new ways to expand their land.
Left ankle long time ago, I think more than 20 years ago, because that time her following her mom to working, and one time the chain break, the log speed from the log downhill hurt and jammed.
Oh, so the log rolled down the hill, came back and hit her in the leg. Wow. So she can stand on it, but it's never going to be fixed. It's going to be like...
They fix and recover themselves that way.
Yeah, it recovered that way.
Operation or surgery, because it's too late.
It was too late, yeah.
Yeah, too late.
So she can still run.
Yes.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
They're fighters, I guess. Mm-hmm. So this here is Kabu, and Kabu is a bit shyer. She doesn't like being on camera, I've been told. Now, this happened years ago, so she's no longer in pain. Her leg has totally healed over. However, she's never going to be able to stand up straight. And so it's just so exciting to see places like Elephant Nature Park that take in the old, the lame, the handicapped, and give them another chance at life. All right, we finally got this one take. So I do my concluding scene here, and it's not exactly easy working with an elephant, a 2-ton animal that doesn't necessarily cooperate on film all the time. So we kept using food to try to like direct it in the right direction, but then Boku here kept turning around, and I was like, ah, come on. And then he'd finally be in place, and then I'd screw up my line. But nonetheless, I think we nailed it. Oh my gosh, he's doing it again. He's scratching himself with the stick. Look at him. The Reader's Digest of the history of the elephants here in Thailand was, when they were first used, they were actually used as military weapons. And they would literally charge the line. And so you can see why this would be a pretty devastating weapon when well trained. When they were no longer needed for military use, they were actually repurposed and brought to the logging industry. Massive logs are being cut down and they'll tow them wherever needed. This actually still goes on today, despite it being made totally illegal. If you go into the back country of Thailand, you'll find people using elephants still for that same purpose. However, once logging became made illegal, there was still an excess of elephants, and so they were brought into the tourism industry. The unfortunate truth, and the reason we're doing Black Tusk, is that majority of these elephant tourism industries are abusing the animals. Today has been so beautiful. I don't know how we got so lucky. The forecast, the weatherman, was extremely wrong. And I couldn't be happier about that. We are in between the mountain range. Beautiful, green, lush. Not too hot today, actually. It's surprisingly nice out. Oh, hello over there. Wow. This is a big one. Look how big she is.
It's time for them to take a bath.
All right, let's go watch. When the males get older, they get their testosterone pumping, and you know how it goes. They get aggressive, and basically it's not safe for anyone to be near those male elephants once they hit maturity. And so the matured male elephants are in a different part of the park where tourists can see them, but they're not allowed to go near them. My mood exactly. I feel you, bruh. It's so hot. This dog looks like he just listened to a Drake album. We are giving these elephants a bath. Elephants love to cool off in this extremely hot temperature. Hello, sit well. Mr. Fluff, look. It looks like an evil henchman's cat.
Pure evil.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, you've kept a lot for us. Coconuts, we got dried tofu, we got some spring roll. These Southeast Asian trunkless elephants. Very social, relatively safe. Guys, you guys, the elephants are kissing. Oh, he just broke it up. What, you don't want to see elephant love? I thought there was a motorboat coming up here, but it was the elephant. It made like the deepest gurgling noise. It sounds like true. Wow, they're all making noises. Oh my gosh. The land before time. Oh my gosh. The land before time here. Oh my gosh.
the baby.
So it's not aggressive then, it's just...
No, it's just playing.
Just playing, yeah.
Playing.
Wow!
Want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
Each of the mahouts has to like carefully watch their elephant because some of them just like go sprinting off around. They've got so many different kinds of elephants coming from different herds, different walks in life. Occasionally it results in tensions. So that's why they're very closely monitored, always done respectfully.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. This is authentic animal interaction. You are seeing elephants just like they would act in the wild because they're treated exactly like they're in the wild. Other than free food, of course, but there's a dog swimming across stream, but the stream is also pushing him down. Oh, look at him. Will he make it? Look at the beautiful surroundings here. This is incredible. And then there's this guy. So right there is a 4-year-old male. You can see by its tusks. Just growing. See you guys. So all of them right now are in the back of that truck because there's actually a volunteer program. You can come to places like Elephant Nature Park and donate your time and your blood, sweat, and tears. They also rehabilitate and take care of. All that green grass. What you gonna do with all that grass? All that grass and such, oh jeez. Hey, water buffalo. We're gonna change the documentary to Black Buffalo. You're gonna be on YouTube, man. So sick. So Yella is actually just telling me that one of the reasons he's in Thailand is because of the vlogs. So now you're in the vlogs.
Thank you, man.
Pleasure to meet you, man.
Yeah.
That's so sick. Looks like something straight out of Noah's Ark. You've got elephants, you've got dogs, you've got water buffaloes. Everyone just living in harmony. The baby was alone. Everyone was like out eating and doing their thing. And then all of a sudden, the mom made some noise, and then all of them are now surrounding the baby, like in defense formation. You can see one of them's peeing. Is that a sign of stress when they pee?
I'm not sure if they're pee. You don't want to stay a bit back.
So this is Darrick here, and Darrick is gonna show us one of the coolest things you'll have ever seen.
Come on! Put him up here! Come on!
The mirror today.
What's going on,
baby? Wow. That is so unbelievable. And because he's built this incredible relationship with him, he actually has a call and they come running when they hear him. They can smell him from afar away because they have incredible sense of smell. Eyesight, not so good, but their hearing and sense of smell is incredible. Wow. Look at that. That is beautiful. So she thinks you're her kid?
It's kind of a parental, sometimes kid, sometimes dad.
And this is Manal, she's the main nanny.
Wow. Look, they're walking hand in hand. And so is she protective over you?
Yeah, this is a mothering response. All you watch the mothers, they have them always tuck them underneath them and check on them. Do this totally this thing.
Wow.
Checking on their young.
That's incredible.
Somehow I became her little one. She says, "Where have you been?"
Do the other elephants have that same response to you? Do they try to tuck you under?
I have been by her mom.
Yeah.
Mostly it's touching me. Ability for elephants to socialize. That is probably the number one factor on how our elephants recover. If there's medical injuries, we provide for that care. The sickness of the soul and the mind and heart is there, and it's only something that if you provide for natural behaviors, you do some part in helping that healing. But their ability to socialize with other elephants is really critical.
I guess the elephants love to play with the tires here. Have you ever seen someone get pushed?
It didn't happen to me. Knocked me right off my feet.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. That was Bolcom, one of our older girls, is part of a nanny of Nawan.
Yeah.
And twice she put me on my ass.
Yeah.
Gotta respect them. You gotta respect the distance, the size, the power. They're a captive wild animal.
Yeah.
And they are a keystone mammal. End story. There's no other reason for losing them.
You know,
other things, the ivory trade and that ridiculous thought that you can trade, you can get currency out of another animal's body parts.
What just happened over the past half an hour has been probably the best thing that could have possibly ever happened for this documentary. So we got to talking with Darrick, and Darrick is one of the people who makes Elephant Nature Park what it is today. He has such an incredible bond with these elephants. He's been here for over 10 years. He's actually married to Lek, who is the leader of Elephant Nature Park. We'll be meeting her tomorrow. It's just incredible. I mean, Elephant Whisperer is the only way I can put it. So I mean, look, they're following him like he's the king of the jungle. Ultimately, what I took away from talking with him was that he believes that elephants should be let to live as naturally as possible. And what does that mean? That means not being bound, being able to socialize with friends and family, and not having harnesses put on their back. We need to let elephants be elephants, and that's exactly what I see happening here at the Elephant Nature Park. If you're gonna come to Chiang Mai, if you're gonna go to anywhere in Southeast Asia, make sure you're choosing the right businesses, and this right here is certainly one of them. It's like there's a carbon monoxide leak. All of the cats are just like passed out throughout here. Okay. Day one of Black Tusk. What a massive success. And you're gonna see a massive change with what this video is gonna do. I have high hopes, and I know that I have an incredibly supportive community behind me that will help me share this video, because that's ultimately what it's gonna come down to, is having you guys champion this message. Alright guys, we just got back to the hotel. We actually got driven home by Darrick. He's just such an authentic dude, like just following his passion and doing it wholeheartedly. He is taking on so much. You're definitely gonna hear more about that from me or from Darrick, hopefully later on. That is the end of the vlog for tonight. I gotta get up pretty soon to do day two at Elephant Nature Park, and I'm really excited to be there. Alright guys, have a good night. Let's get lost again tomorrow.
Fan of the day.
We got arrested in Thailand.